Hey Tech Nitwittians, we are here with another awesome video. We have the TG01 and we are going to be throwing this black bad mamma jamma of a graphics card in. It's a RX 6700 XT. We have everything out here that we're going to need for our install today. We have a PCI 8 pin, and this is a male to female adapter. So we have the female end right here, the male ends are right here, and it can also, it's a 6+2, that's what they mean by this. And you want to get this because, like, this card has an 8-pin and a 6-pin on it. If you just get an 8-pin to 8-pin, you're going to be sorry because it's not going to work. So other than that, we do have the 400-watt power supply that is already in here. I don't have the 500-watt power supply. It's in the case still. I got to switch them around, so it's a little bit confusing. But this is what's going to be in here with the 3060 that's already in here. All right, guys, that's going to be the video for today. I am going to go over the benchmark numbers that the RTX 3060 got really quick. With the TimeSpy benchmark, we scored 7,669. Our first graphics score was 57.14, and our second one was 47.83. All right, guys, we're gonna get this bad mamma jamma ripped open, and we are gonna get the RX 6700 XT installed. All right, guys, we're gonna dive right into this TG01. We're gonna come to the rear, and we gotta unplug some stuff. Everything's already off, so if you don't have your computer off, shut it down. Go ahead and unplug everything from the rear. If you have a wireless Bluetooth guy, you can leave that in there. We are not taking the motherboard out. But we're gonna come around to the rear right away, and we're gonna take all the screws out that we can, just to make this a simpler job. You are gonna need one of the extra screws for the power supply. It will require 4 vs. 3. So first screw's right here, second screw is right here, third screw's right here, fourth screw, fifth screw. So we're gonna start from right from the top, and this is the case screw that's retained. Here's our GPU screw. And then our power supply. All right, guys, with this case, you're gonna pull back and then out. All right, guys, so we're gonna be quick and dirty with this. We're gonna go ahead and unplug our graphics card. Don't mind my RTX 3060, it has lost its skirt. It feels that it needs to be a nudist now. Go on and join the nudist colony, and she has lost her skirt. You know, HP's wonderful craftsmanship. But that's what it looks like originally. One thing that you're noticing that we don't have these cages in here. So if you see, I have a hard drive up here. I had to move this hard drive up here because of the length of the graphics card, it gets in the way. So if I try putting this cage in, of course you can't because it's in the way. I mean, you could probably put the lower one in there. I don't see why you would. But you don't need these cages for anything on this computer. They can be all the way out. So guys, we are gonna go ahead and grab our 7-pin down at the bottom right here, then our 4-pin right here, and our 4-pin right here. And let's get this out. And then there's a little tabby down here. I don't know if you guys can see that. It pushes in right there. You're gonna push this in, and you're gonna take your hand and push from the back of the power supply and push forward, and it's out. And that is that power supply literally out of the cage. And then we're going to come here and we're going to throw our 500 watt in real quick. If I don't stop throwing stuff all around my set. This side is going to go towards the inside. We're going to line it up, push pressure against it, and push forward. And it locks in. We're going to come and do the same thing in reverse. We're going to take our 7-pin and plug it in. We're going to grab the short cable, not the one with the brown wires, and then we're going to put it right here. This tab goes towards the front of the case. And then our real long brown and black wire is going to come around top. And this tab goes towards the rear of the case. This tab right here, towards the rear of the case. And that is our 500 watt power supply installed. These extra cables are not needed for right now. This one you can tuck away, and there's a little loop right here. But you are going to need this for the GPU. So let's just prepare things real quick, and let's take our 8-pin to 6+2-pin adapter and go ahead and send her on home. She's now attached to that. Now we can take our RX 6700 XT and we're going to have to Jumanji this wonderful card in here. Otherwise, I could remove the hard drive. It would make it a little bit easier. But you're going to have to kind of come in, make sure this is on the inside. And you got to kind of do a wiggle and jiggle. I'll make sure these wires are out of our way. And then there we go. We are in like sin. And that's pretty much that installed. We are going to come around here and we are now going to plug our dual 8 pin in, which we're going to take our 6 plus 2 and we're going to take one off because this requires an 8 pin and a 6 pin. We're going to let the wires come up above. We're going to get our 8 pin in, make sure you don't see any gaps, and get our 6 pin in. And that is that installed. Go ahead and slap your, make sure the door is closed. And we're going to slap our case side back on. I know you guys are probably like, you make this look really easy, Tech Nitwit. I know. And we're going to come to the rear and we're going to start sticking some screws in. So the first one I do is of course, the GPU. And then you can do the case screw. And then we're going to have to catch our power supply. It is a little bit easier to have this open to do, so you can put some pressure on it. But if you get a screw to thread, it'll suck it back. And then you're not going to use the same screws that you used with the 400 watt, which were these two. You're going to do the corners and then these two right here. All right, guys, that is pretty much the install done. I know I made that look quick and easy, and we're going to get over to a benchmark to show proof of concept. And then, yeah. And I thank you guys for all my subscribers. If you like the video, like the video. If you dislike the video, dislike the video. If you think I could do something better or different, hey, throw it down in the comments. It really, really helps me. If you need some info about the power supplies, I do have a video on that. I'll link that down in the description down below, how to order the 500 watt if you need it. And of course, there are more available 67 and 6600 XTs than the NVIDIA cards because of mining right now. So guys, we're going to hop over to the benchmark and we're going to get that rocking and rolling. Hey, Tech Nitwitians, we just got this benchmark done and we're going to go over it really quick. This is a TimeSpy DirectX 12 and we scored 9,667. Our first GPU score was an 8236 FPS and our second was a 6350. That is a difference. Our original score was 7,669 and our first GPU score was 5714. This is with the RTX 3060. And our second GPU score was 47.83. One thing I will say is you guys got to make sure that you don't just use the generic drivers. You want to make sure that you install drivers from AMD. It is very, very important. Other than that, guys, this is an awesome upgrade. If you got a 1660, 1660 Super, 1660 Ti, 1650, 1650 Super, or even a 2060, this is going to be an upgrade for you. This is going to be a step up. I'm going to give this 2 thumbs up of approval. It runs well in the TG. It doesn't overheat. Other than that, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. I thank all my subscribers for subscribing. If you made it this far, thank you very much. If you like, go ahead and like. If you dislike, go ahead and dislike. If you're going to dislike, at least tell me why you're disliking so I know what I can try to improve, or I can just say I don't really care. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. Stuff like that. Other than that, guys, and my Tech Nitwitians, thank you for watching. I'm out, y'all.